Hello everyone, Professor Franz here, and today we're going to talk about price discrimination. Here is the definition of price discrimination. When selling the same good or service, the firm is charging different consumers different prices according to their different willingness to pay. And the purpose is profit maximization. The firm is trying to take away the consumer surplus from the consumers and transfer that consumer surplus into the firm's profit. You can practice this as long as you face a downward sloping demand curve. So you don't need to be a monopolist to practice price discrimination. You can be, say, a monopolistic competitive firm. As long as you face a downward sloping demand curve, you can practice price discrimination. Here are the first, second, and third degree price discrimination. So the first degree price discrimination actually doesn't exist in the real world. We only introduce that for educational purpose. So I want you to imagine a sci-fi movie where there is a seller who can tell your exact willingness to pay. And the seller is going to charge you a price that's exactly equal to willingness to pay. So your price is equal to your willingness to pay, and therefore your consumer surplus is equal to zero. The second degree price discrimination is this. In a nutshell, it's quantity discount. So for example, buy one, get one 50% off. That's a quantity discount. Then that's the second degree price discrimination. Finally, the third degree price discrimination is just market segregation. So the firm is going to separate consumers into elastic group and an inelastic group. If you're the elastic group, that means you care a lot about the price. So the firm is going to charge you a lower price. But if you belong to the inelastic group, the firm is going to charge you a higher price. We are going to first compare first degree price discrimination with a monopoly with no price discrimination. And for simplicity, I am going to assume that there is no fixed cost and our marginal cost is constant. And therefore, your marginal cost is exactly equal to average total cost. So we're going to start with the firm that there is no price discrimination. The firm is going to set marginal revenue equal to marginal cost, and we are going to produce a quantity Q star. And when I decide how much to charge, I'm going to go back to my demand curve, and I'm going to charge a price P star to every consumer. So you can see that consumer surplus is equal to the area below the demand curve, above the price P star, and therefore consumer surplus is that blue triangle. And the firm's profit is going to be equal to price minus average total cost times the quantity. So that will be the yellow block. And we have a deadweight loss. Why is that? Because according to demand curve, there is someone whose willingness to pay is here. That's pretty high. But this person's willingness to pay is lower than the price. So this person is not going to buy the product. At the same time, the person's willingness to pay is higher than the marginal cost of producing that good. And this transaction is lost, and that's just too bad. And that's the reason why we have deadweight loss. So that's no price discrimination, and we have a deadweight loss. Moving on to the first degree price discrimination. Remember that in this case, we imagine there's a sci-fi movie, and the seller can tell every single consumer's willingness to pay. So the firm is going to charge the first consumer, oh, your willingness to pay is here, so you pay that amount. And the second consumer, oh, your willingness to pay is there, so you pay that amount, and so on and so forth. Notice that in this scenario, your demand curve is actually your marginal revenue curve, because for each unit, I charge you the price, and the price is exactly my marginal revenue. So I set marginal revenue equal to my marginal cost, and therefore I'm producing a higher quantity in the example of first degree price discrimination. So I'm producing a quantity big Q star. Notice that there is no deadweight loss, because every consumer whose willingness to pay is higher than the marginal cost will get the product. But is there a consumer surplus? No, the consumer surplus is zero because you pay exactly your willingness to pay. and all consumer surplus will go to the firm's profit. Is the outcome efficient? Yes. Is it fair? No, because the firm grabs everything.